Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and I'm going to talk about, in this video, Mr. M.F. Doom, aka Daniel Doomhalay, one of the most enigmatic rappers of all time, distinct and original in just about every way a rapper can be. His voice is raspy and deep, his wordplay always clever, and then what he raps about. His references are consistently obscure, kind of nerdy. And in his songs, he's constantly building this narrative about himself as this character based upon the comic villain Victor Von Doom, aka Dr. Doom. I've been listening to this guy for years. I think he's one of the best modern MCs out there, period. I love numerous projects of his, Mad Villainy, his solo albums, Danger Doom, Victor Vaughn. And in this video, I'm essentially going to trip back a little bit and go over a lot of his older songs and sort of talk about what I think are my five favorite MF Doom verses. My first favorite verse comes from what I think is one of Doom's most underrated full-length projects, Born. The song is That's That. Doom sings on the song, not something he does all that often. It was one of the first tracks, if not, I believe, the first track to drop from this full-length album when it was about to come out. And when I heard it, I was floored. Mostly because right as the song starts, Doom kicks it off with so many relentless rhymes. Throwing so many internal rhymes within a bar, the words are essentially dizzying. And not only that, but the words and the references are completely nutty too. But as the lyrics draw on, it becomes apparent that not only is this song a bit of a, hey, hello, how you doing, I'm back kind of tune for MF Doom, but it's also a bit of a slight against people who enlist in the military. Already woke, spared a joke, barely spoke, rarely smoked, stared at folks, when properly provoked, mirror broke. Here, share strawberry morning, gone in, more important, spawning. Torn in, poor men sworn in. Cornish hen switching positions, auditioning morticians, sought in a vision, ignoring prison, ignoramuses enlist in sound dumb, found him drowning cow's dung, crowns flung. Most definitely one of Doom's most fiery moments. The dude can seem kind of lax at times, but he totally goes in when he needs to. Now, it's not really Doom's speed or flow that attracts me to him necessarily, though, when he does go that route, it does end up good. It's really his punchlines, his references that really wow me, and this next track, which comes off of Vaudeville Villain, is loaded with some of my favorite one-liners of his. The song is called The Drop, and my highlights from the track are as follows. Yep, listening to nothing, taking no suggestions, or destructive criticisms that can't improve on perfection. Don't let the drama get ya, in the only genre of music where the fans shoot the messenger. Bitch, talk behind your back like a catcher. Either MYOB or BYO stretcher. MYOB meaning mind your own business. Remember me, God, clean Tim's with emery board. He only came to save the game like a memory card. And write a rhyme like a book report and sell it to a rookie. You could tell by the hook he bought. You ain't know he sell hooks and choruses. They couldn't bang the slang if they looked in thesauruses.
Funny. That's pretty funny.
This next verse comes off of the opening track to one of MF Doom's most popular albums, Food. The song is called Beef Rap. It fits right into the concept of the album with a load of food references in the songs themselves and the song titles. And this track also works into an ongoing narrative where MF Doom is making fun of the current state of hip-hop, specifically in this track, the time-honored tradition of the rap beef. Beef rap could lead to getting teeth capped or even a wreath for Mod Dukes on some grief crap. I suggest you change your diet. It can lead to high blood pressure if you fry it, or even a stroke, heart attack, heart disease. It ain't no snurry back once arteries start to squeeze. Take the easy way out, phony. Until then, they know they wouldn't be talking that baloney in the bullpen. But maybe my favorite moment on the entire track comes right at the start of the third verse. To all rappers, shut up with your shutting up, and keep your shirt on, or at least a button up. Yuck. These rhymesayers is stripping males. Out of work jerks since they shut down Chippendales. Raw as hell and funny. Doom is just such a weird outsider, and yet he just writes so well, And he's so imaginative and vivid with a lot of the stuff that he says, especially as he dives into these songs where he is trying to build this backstory about his character, considering that his character is based on a villain and that he follows superheroes, he follows villains, he follows comic books. The origin story is something that is really important to MF Doom and the songs that he writes, namely on songs like Curls, which features one of my favorite verses off of Mad Villainy. And this track, I think, is one of the best tracks when it comes to Doom building up that origin story and sort of putting an image of his past into the mind of the listener. Villain get the money like Curls. They just trying to get a nut like Squirrels in his mad world. Land of milk and honey with the swirls, where reckless naked girls get necklaces of pearls. Compliments of the town jeweler. Left back now schooler trying to sound cooler. On the microphone known as the crown ruler. He went to Ma when he said he found the moolah. $500-something laying right there in the street. Huh. Now let's try to get something to eat. He turned 4 and started flowing to the poor. That's about when he first started going raw. Keep the dro in the drawer. A rhyming klepto who couldn't go up in the store no more. You get this image that he is sort of the ruler of the world. Everybody else is a smaller, lesser, tinier, squirrel-like being. And then we get reckless naked girls getting necklaces of pearls. And then he's saying that he's a left-back now schooler, trying to sound cooler instead of an old schooler, but he's graduating right now because his career was sort of put off, so he's not quite an old schooler, he's a now schooler. And what's interesting with Doom is that we constantly get these references to this cartoony, made-up, very strange past, and also his reality, too, to the point where it kind of becomes hard to tell when he's telling the truth about his true self, the man behind the mask, or if he's kind of building up the character that he's constantly portraying. But on the song Doomsday, it's one of the rare moments where it feels like Doom is still being himself. He's not quite 100% into the character as we know him as today. And right on one of the opening tracks to the LP, the title track to the LP, Doomsday, he essentially delivers a few bars that I think are very telling about himself. Ever since the womb till I'm back where my brother went, that's what my tomb will say, right above my government, Doomalay. Either unmarked or engraved, hey, who's to say? I wrote this one in BCDCO section. If you don't believe me, go get bagged and check then. Cell number 17, up under the top bunk. Essentially, Doom here talking about the death of his brother. If you're familiar with MF Doom's career, you know he used to rap in a group with his brother named KMD until the unfortunate passing of his brother. This kind of delayed his rap career. Not only that, but the fact that the group's last album, Black Bastards, had been shelved. Further in this group of lines, he talks about his tombstone and how it's going to have his government Doomalay on it. We get his real name being referenced in a song. And then we get a few lines where MF Doom starts off a lot of lines throughout his career saying, I wrote this one, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, and he'll talk about a funny situation in which he wrote the line he is rapping you right now. But on this particular track, we are maybe getting the start of this trend with him talking about how he wrote this one while in jail. And if you don't believe him, go to this particular jail in this particular cell and check under the top bunk. He must have left something up there for you to verify that it was him. It's stuff like this that gets me listening to Doom songs, re-listening to Doom songs, picking up new things, and anticipating everything he's gonna do for the foreseeable future. He's so funny. He's so clever, in my opinion, incredibly creative, and on top of that, he sort of has this ability that other MCs out there just don't, and that is he's created this character that he can truly become and mold in any way that he wants to mold him. He can have this character go out and do anything that his mind can create, and then he can rap about it. And not to say that there are MCs out there that totally make shit up, there are, but Doom clearly takes advantage of this advantage in possibly the best way a rapper ever could, and maybe ever will. Those are my thoughts. Those are my 5 favorite MF Doom verses, all caps, when you spell the man's name. Remember that. Okay? Okay. Transition, what are your favorite MF Doom lyrics or verses ever? Let me know. I'm totally curious. Let me know down in the comments. Come on, buddy. Come on, man. Let me know. Anthony Fantano, Mr. Dumoulin, forever.